If you're someone who wears your shoes all the time inside your house or even just keeps them on while running in quickly for something you forgot, you might rethink things when you learn what your shoes are bringing inside your house.
There are a lot of shoes out there pounding the pavement. The average man owns 12 pairs, the average woman, 27. That's a lot of shoes carrying a lot of germs right into your house. A University of Arizona study sampled shoes only 2 weeks old and found over 400,000 bacteria just on the outside of the shoes. And 27% of that bacteria was E. coli. 39% of shoes sampled by the University of Houston had something scarier, C. diff. That's an antibiotic-resistant form of bacteria.
Unless you're like really bleaching your floors or whatever, your regular cleaning may kill some of the other bacteria. What it might not do is get rid of the C. diff.
So we thought we'd do our own experiment. Terry, a WGN employee, volunteered his family's footwear to be tested just to see how dangerous it is to wear your shoes in the house. I also added two pairs of my own. They swabbed all six pairs in the lab at the University of Chicago, and here's what they found.
Interestingly, we found no C. diff. We did not find C. diff.
That's the good news, but hold on.
For six out of six, we found the environmental organisms. In only one pair of boots did we find gram-negative enteric organisms, not E. coli, but in that family.
That's right. No way. E. coli. The E. coli family means some type of fecal matters involved.
Wow. Was that your shoe?
Tyler's, I bet.
How's it make you feel to hear that?
That's disgusting.
Yeah, that's pretty gross.
The technical name for the bacteria found on the shoe is Panaetoia aglomerans, and here's what it looks like. It doesn't look very scary. In fact, the scariest looking petri dishes are the ones with the least harmful bacteria. These all contain environmental bacteria. They won't hurt you unless you've got a compromised immune system. Terry and Lisa might be freaking out, but they shouldn't. The amount of E. coli family bacteria found on their shoes is less than what you'd find on an average toilet seat.
They should be worried. I wouldn't, you know, get nervous about it. I think we all probably carry different bacteria on our shoes of different kinds. But, you know, for cleanliness sake, take the shoes off at the door.
The new rule is the shoes off at the back door.
Hallelujah.
So if you're worried about what might be on your family's shoes after this story, the doctor says simply use those antibacterial wipes on the bottoms of your shoes. She says they should remove the bulk of the bacteria, even those in the E. coli family.